Hello students, welcome. First chapter is Introduction to Operating System. Till now you have seen different operating systems like Windows, Linux, Unix, Android, macOS. Okay, but what is meant by actual operating system? So you can say that it is a program that manages a computer's hardware. It also provides a basis for application program and acts as an intermediary between computer user and the computer hardware. Without operating system, user will not able to interface with the computer. Again, operating system provides set of system programs which can control and automate hardware as well as software activity. Operating system objectives and functions. Operating system services provides functions that are helpful to the user. There are different functions which are user interface, program execution, input-output operation, file system manipulation, communication, and last one is the error detection. So first we'll start with the user interface. Every OS has user interface. Actually, there are three forms of user interface, that is command line interface, batch interface, and GUI, that is graphical user interface. In command line interface, user can type text commands and a method to enter the commands. In batch interface, user can give commands and directive to control them are entered into the files and those files are executed. In GUI, that is graphical user interface, a Windows system with a pointing device to direct I/O choose from menus and make selections and a keyboard to enter the text. Next is the program execution. The system must be able to load a program into memory to run the program. The program must be able to end its execution either normally or abnormally. Okay. Then I/O operation. A program while execution requires I/O, which includes a file or I/O device. Then file system manipulation. It includes creation and deletion of files. The file permissions are the operations on files and directories. Then communication. There are many cases in which one process wants to exchange information with the other process. These communications are implemented via shared memory in which two or more executing processes read and write to share sections of memory. Okay, that is nothing but the communication. And last objective is the error detection. Operating system needs to be detecting and correcting errors constantly for each type of error. So these are the operating system objectives and functions. Functions of operating system. There are three functions. First one is the resource allocation, then accounting, and third one is the protection and security. In resource allocation, when there are multiple users or multiple jobs running at the same time, resources must be allocated to each of them. To manage all these resources, operating system is used. Next is accounting. To keep track of which users use how much and what kind of computer resources, record keeping is used. Then protection and security. The owner's information stored in a multi-user or networked computer system may want to control use of that information. This type of security is provided by operating system. For example, password protection, gaining access to system resources, etc. Components of computer system. You can see the figure. Into that, the core part is the hardware, then system software, then application software, and last one is the user. The hardware part, it provides the basic computing resources. That means it includes CPU, memory, and input-output devices. Next, the operating system acts as an intermediary between computer user and the computer hardware. The operating system controls and coordinates the use of hardware resources among various users' application programs. Then application programs. These are different kind of programs which are written in various languages to solve the computing problems of the users. Then last one is the user. Users of a computer system try to solve different complex computing problems. The users can be people, machine, or other computers. Roles and objectives of operating system. There are different objectives of operating system. Into that, first, it helps to start computer using startup program which are stored in ROM and booting process of secondary storage. Again, it provides a user interface to user. We have seen earlier that it provides command line interface, graphical user interface. Next, it controls each and every activity of all input-output devices using device driver. Then it provides runtime environment to user's program. Again, it provides set of system software to user for the software development. Next objective of operating system is it manages main memory and secondary memory. It provides network communication facility also. Again, it provides data management. It helps in user application and data using password facility. It accounts resource usage. It provides utilities and services to the system. Next is the operating system as a user view and system view. First, we'll see user view. The main goal of operating system from single user's view is its ease of use, maximize the work that the user is performing. Performance is the important to the user, but such systems are optimized for the single user experience rather than the requirement of multiple users. When a user is working on mainframe, other users are accessing the same computer through other terminal. These users share resources and may exchange information. The operating system in such cases is designed to maximize resource utilization to assure that all available CPU time, memory, and I/O are used efficiently and that no individual user takes more than her fair share. The operating system in which user is working on workstations connected to network is designed to compromise between individual usability and resource utilization, because these users may have to share the network as well as individual resources. The user interface for mobile computers is generally with the touch screen, where the user interacts with the system by pressing and swiping fingers across the screen rather than using a physical keyboard and mouse. The operating system in which user is working on workstations connected to network is designed to compromise between individual usability and resource utilization. System view. The operating system can be viewed as resource allocator. A computer system has many resources that may required to solve a problem. Resources means what? CPU time, memory space, file storage space, I/O devices, and so on. The operating system acts as a manager of these resources. There may be conflicting requests between for the resources. The operating system decides how to allocate them to specific program and users so that it can operate the computer system efficiently and fairly. The operating system controls the various IO devices and users program. For this purpose, the OS uses control program, which manages the execution of user program to prevent errors and improper use of computer. Evolution of operating system. Traditionally, there was a single user, single processor, and single processing operating system. With the requirement of user and the time, there was a great evolution in the operating systems. They were based on different parameters like users, number of processors, and number of processes. So there are different types of operating systems. You can see that batch operating system, multi-programming, desktop, then time sharing, real time, distributed, parallel, multimedia, and handheld system. We have to study all these types of operating systems. Now we will start with the first operating system, that is batch operating system. The users of batch operating system do not interact with the computer directly. Each user prepares his job on an offline device like punch card and submit it to computer operator. To speed up processing, jobs with the similar needs are batched together and run as a group. But there was another problem too. Suppose one job is in C language and other one is in Java. We know that both the jobs now require entirely different environment for their execution. So the IO magnetic tapes needed to be loaded and unloaded again and again. As number of users increased, number of jobs will also going to be increased. It was really time consuming process. Most of the time wasted, it is wasted in IO work only, and CPU remain idle for too long. Then a solution to this problem was devised that jobs requiring similar environmental conditions will be submitted altogether within a batch. Since similar jobs were put together in a batch, this system was termed as a batch system. So for this system, a lot of manual work is reduced. Execution becomes fast and well managed. CPU's idle time is reduced. Repetitive use of punch card and magnetic tapes will also be reduced. But there are some disadvantages also. Sequential execution. This is one of the major disadvantages for the batch system. Jobs in a batch are always executed sequentially. For example, if there are 4 jobs in one batch, then they are always executed one by one, and the output is obtained only once when all 4 jobs are completed. Second advantage is the starvation. It means different jobs in a single batch might take different amount of time in execution. This might lead to starvation of some jobs. Suppose there are 4 jobs in a batch and the first job takes too long to execute, then other 3 jobs in the same batch will have to be wait for a longer time. Third is the no interaction between job and user. Once a batch is submitted to the computer, the user no longer able to interact with any job. Suppose there is a job which requires the user to give the input data during runtime. Now he must have to wait until all jobs in the batch are completed. So the overall execution time is increased a lot. Next operating system is multiprogramming. It increases CPU utilization by managing jobs in such a way that CPU always remain busy with one job. Operating system features are IO subroutine supplied by the system. It manages memory properly. Then it does CPU scheduling. Again, allocation of devices. How multiprogramming works. Several jobs are kept in main memory at the same time, and the CPU is multiplexed among them. That means several jobs are ready for the execution. If memory can hold several programs, then CPU can switch to one another whenever program is waiting for an IO to complete. This is nothing but the multi-programming. Various resources are utilized effectively. It do not provide for user interaction with the computer system. So in multi-programming operating system, CPU will never become idle. The system looks fast as all tasks runs in parallel. Short jobs are completed faster than the longer time jobs. Multi-programming systems support multiply users. Resources are used nicely. Total read time taken to execute program or job decreases. Response time is shorter. But there are some disadvantages also. It is difficult to program a system because of complicated schedule handling. Tracking of all processes is sometimes difficult. Due to high load of tasks, long time jobs have to wait long. Next operating system is time sharing or multitasking operating system. It is a logical extension of multi-programming system. Multiple users simultaneously access the system through terminals. Processor's time is shared among multiple users. That is, the CPU is multiplexed among several jobs that are kept in memory on a disk. But the CPU is allocated to a job only if the job is in memory. Time sharing systems are also known as multitasking. If the several jobs, next operating system is time sharing or multitasking operating system. Multiple users simultaneously access the system through terminals. Processor's time is shared among multiple users, that is, the CPU is multiplexed among several jobs that are kept in memory and on disk. But the CPU is allocated to job only if the job is in memory. If several jobs are ready to run at the same time, CPU scheduling is required. If processes don't fit in the memory, swapping moves them in and out to run. Some features provided by time sharing operating system, that these are available for users to access data and code. Should do memory management. Again, it is doing CPU scheduling. Synchronization. Then it ensures that deadlock and define waiting does not occur. Some disadvantages are also there. It consumes much resources, so it needs special operating system. Switching between tasks becomes sometimes sophisticated as there are lot of users and applications running which may hang up the system. So the time sharing should have some specific of hardware. Next operating system is desktop operating system. It is also called as client operating system. For example, Windows, Macintosh, Linux. They are personal computers, meaning computers system dedicated to a single user. I/O devices used for these systems are keyboard, mic, display, screen, small printers. Main focus is on user convenience and responsiveness. These systems can adopt technology developed for larger operating system. Often individual have sole use of computer and do not need advanced CPU utilization and protection features. Features are, it is single user, utilization is no longer a concern, emphasis is on user interface and API. There are some disadvantages also. Openness to virus attack is a major disadvantage. If any problem affected in OS, you may lose all the content which have been stored already. Unwanted users can use your own system. Next is the real-time operating system. An embedded system is a computer system designed to perform one or few dedicated functions, often with the real-time computing constraints. These devices are varying in nature, from car engines to washing machine, VCR, microwave. These systems are designed to perform very specific tasks. These systems perform very primitive tasks, and therefore operating system provides limited feature to it. Very little user interface is provided by the operating system. Real-time operating system is used in embedded systems. A sensor gives input to the computer. The computer analyzes data and adjusts controls to modify the sensor inputs. A real-time system has well-defined fixed time constraints. A real-time system works correctly only if it returns the correct output with its time span. Distributed operating system. It is a collection of processors that do not share memory or clock. Each processor has its own local memory. The processors in the system are connected through a communication network. A communication takes place using a protocol. A distributed system provides user access to various system resources. Access to shared resources allows computation speed up, increased data availability, enhanced reliability, efficient functionality, etc. There are some advantages. It gives more performance than single system. More resources can be added easily. Resources like printers can be shared on multiple PCs. Along with that, there are some disadvantages also. Security problem due to sharing. Bandwidth is another problem. If there is large data, then all network wires to be replaced with which leads to expensive. Overloading is another problem in distributed operating system. Parallel operating systems are the interface between parallel computers and the applications that are executed on them. They translate the hardware's capabilities into concepts usable by programming languages. Currently, SMP computers are the most widely used multiprocessors. Parallel computing is the simultaneous execution of the same task on multiple processors in order to obtain results faster. The idea behind is on the fact that the processes of solving problem usually can be divided into smaller tasks, which may be carried out simultaneous with the same coordination. The term parallel processor architecture or multiprocessing architecture are sometimes used for the computer with more than one processor available for processing. There are some advantages: overcome memory constraints, save time and money, cost saving, advantage of non-local resources. Some disadvantages are also there. It becomes increasingly difficult and expensive to design and produce shared memory machines with ever increasing number of processors. Lack of scalability between memory and CPU. Parallel systems do not guarantee overall proportionality. Multimedia system is capable of processing multimedia data and applications. It is characterized by processing, storage, generation, and manipulation of multimedia information. Recent computer systems can store multimedia data. It consists of audio and video files. That means MP3, DVD movies, video conferencing, and short clips and news stories. Multimedia applications also include live speeches, live sports events, etc. So these multimedia systems must be computer controlled. Multimedia systems are integrated, and information that they handle must be represented digitally. The interface to the final presentation of media is usually interactive. Last is the handheld system. It includes personal digital assistants such as cellular telephones, pocket PCs. These are very special purpose embedded operating systems. Size of such devices is limited, due to which they have a small amount of memory, slow processors, and small display screens. PDAs are convenient and portable to use. Wireless technology can be used with handheld devices such as Bluetooth. This allows us to access emails and web browsers. Examples of handheld OS are Linux OS, Windows, Android, Packet PC, Palm OS, etc. Thank you.